Okay, we're putting it back together right now, but let's back up to last weekend. And I didn't get a whole lot of footage as we took this thing apart down to the center bearing and replaced it, but I got bits and pieces, so I'm gonna mash them all together to make as good a video as I can. This is the intro. It's being made after the wrap-up, so I hope you don't mind. Everything is mixed up.
Try that.
Yeah, they're long since out. Yeah, that was the final hurrah. We got some links. Oh, 4 or 5 inches, I guess. Well, we got the separation filmed, and I haven't been able to get much more footage, but the backbone and the turbines over here. We've got the forward section of the engine right here. Let's take a quick look at that. All right, we've got rags and all of the compressor outlet holes to make sure nothing dropped in. We've got our rag over the center bearing. Let's see if I can shine some light on that. This is the shaft from the compressor that is turned by the turbine. And you can just barely see, let's see, in there where the light is. Those are the rollers, the balls actually, of the dual row ball bearing thrust bearing. And this is the bearing retainer. Tomorrow, we're gonna work on getting those out. Now we're gonna take that out tomorrow because I was busy most of the day today building a rotor jack and I forgot to photograph it as it was going in. So I can't show you it, but I can show you the rotor jack from another engine to give you an idea what they look like. This is the one out of a 1500. It's very simple. It's a big heavy plate that bolts to part of the casing, the inlet casing. There's a round circle. We just find one that has bolt holes and has some strength to it. We cut the piece of steel and drill the holes to fit that bolt circle. And this particular one has a threaded plate. Other ones have a nut welded on, and then the threaded rod allows adjustment. This is actually a nice little roller bearing. This allows the compressor to be turned while it's on the rotor jack. The one I built is, this is like a roller. The one I built is a flat surface. And what it does is it is in this position. It prevents the compressor rotor from falling downward once we remove the thrust bearing. And as you guys know from watching my other videos, the thrust bearing is the only thing keeping the shaft, the main shaft with the compressor and the turbine, in the engine from either going forwards or backwards. There's only one point of axial support, that's the thrust bearing. There are other bearings that are radial support, they're roller bearings. So with the thrust bearing removed, the rotor can crunch down through the engine and wreck a lot of stuff. With the rotor jack, it's held upward, held from going downward, supported, and that allows us to work on the engine. Sounds easy, doesn't it? Drill a few holes, cut a plate, cut some threaded rod, stick it together, slap it in the engine, make sure something doesn't fall out. It is easy. Just the trick is making it fit into a very, very tight space with very little room to move, and it has to interface with and support the main rotor of a jet engine without wrecking it or even scratching it. So you have to be careful, but it is a very simple device. And okay, it took me a little bit too long. It took me almost all day to make it, but it's in there, it's doing its job, and this engine is almost priceless. So there you go. Now the Orenda is a bit of an unusual engine because the splines, the splines on the shaft, they transmit the power from the turbine, the rotational power, to the compressor, but the connection longitudinally is accomplished by another piece. This is the tension member which holds the compressor to the turbine in the Orenda. And these giant Acme threads, they're never actually even tightened. This thing is screwed in all the way, but not torqued, into the compressor. And it's screwed in all the way to the turbine. And then the ability to turn this is locked by the locking mechanism we saw earlier in the locking coupling. So this rod is not tightened. It's just in all the way, and it can't go forward, can't go backwards. But it handles all the tension, the axial load, between the compressor and the turbine. It makes it very easy to take the engine apart. This thing was 60 years old, and it came undone by hand. Actually, you saw me undoing it. Hey, it is coming up. Look at that, like magic. Unless it gets caught. Well, we got the midframe off and we got the thrust bearings out of the midframe. Now we're going to try to put the thrust bearings back together, put them inside the midframe, right over there, right there. And then the goal is to get the midframe back onto the front of the engine. This is the compressor, and get all these lines and things hooked back up. So that's what we're doing next. Okay, the main thrust bearing, one of two. Brand new, going into the Orenda. Split in a race. Hot, coming through. Get it while it's hot. Good, perfect. I have a nicely heated interbearing spacer. Beautiful. And this outer companion. Just like that. Okay, forward bearing, rear race. Nicely heated. Beautiful. Just the way it's supposed to go.
Hot, 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 hot.
Last inner race going on. A juicy 300 degrees. Look at that. Perfect. Where's my metal ring? There it is. A little bit of weight to hold it down. But it's all happy. Here we go, two installed ball bearings, the main thrust bearing for an Orenda 14. Oh, look at that. Isn't that appropriate? Sound good? Two separate ball bearings, a match set. Okay, we've got the bearing cartridge was heated and slipped on over the two individual bearings. This is the main thrust bearing assembly. Just gotta wait till this cools down a bit and we'll be installing it in the midframe. Listen to that. Okay, we've got our bearing cartridge in. We've got our heat shield air seal in. Besides lock wire, here's another way to secure bolts and nuts. Tab washers. We've got our main lock nut, the lock tab and the lock washer locking it. It's our main thrust bearing. Now we have to turn this housing, this midframe, over. And we've got to stick it on here and hook all this stuff back up. Ready to go on. Perfect fit. I like it. Okay, now all we've got to do is put all these bolts back in. And each one was an adventure in itself. And we've got to hook up all the lines that cross the split line here. So that's going to take about a day to hook it all up. And then we can finish with the installation or the tightening of the main coupling nut. Okay, this is the coupling that transmits the torque. I'll show you the other side of it. It's this great big thing right here. That's what takes the power from the turbine to the compressor. So let's put this on. It's got an index mark right there, a little one, and two right here, so we'll put it on the correct spline. Just make sure that it's off by one. We'll be putting that on. Then, let me grab the camera here. And we've got a lock washer, a tab washer. There's a slot in the shaft right there. This tab goes down in. Then this nut will attach this driven spline to the back of the compressor. And that'll be the end of our main thrust bearing installation. But before we tighten this up, we're gonna make sure that two case halves are stuck together. And after that, it's just building it back up the way we took it down, and then the engine test. So until then, thanks for watching.